भाई को
The non-Hindi speaking states have been assured by no less a person than the former Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, a Democrat to the marrow of his bones, that as long as these states desire, English should continue to be the official language in addition to Hindi, and Hindi will not be imposed on unwilling people. Recently in Varanasi, the Honorable Home Minister has declared that Hindi alone is the only national official language, and all file works and correspondence are taking place in Hindi only. In fact, letters and communications are sent in Hindi only from the center to the non-Hindi speaking states. MPs from the south are also receiving replies and letters in Hindi. This is nothing but the high-handedness of the union government to impose Hindi on the non-Hindi speaking people. Similarly, of late, the names of all schemes and programs are being given in Hindi, and no English translation is provided. With the result, the people from non-Hindi speaking areas, in fact, MPs, are also confused about the purpose of schemes, and they are not able to explain to the people about the aims and objectives of the schemes. Though the centre is spending crores of rupees of these schemes, with only
Make your point. You are reading. You are not supposed to read in zero hour.
Only one minute. We take strong objection to the naming of schemes in India against English, which was the practice earlier. There is a demand for including all the state official languages.
Please. Whoever reads, it will not go on record. It shall not go on record. I am saying it in English for your convenience.
The Punjab Assembly has passed a resolution.
No, that has to be discussed. As of now, you know the procedure.
The Punjab Assembly.
We can't read in zero.
The Punjab
Assembly. Yes,
sir. No. The Punjab Assembly.
All the languages of India. They should be respected. They should be promoted, and they should be encouraged. No imposition, no opposition to any Indian language. Sri Prasanna Acharya.
Thank you very much, sir, for allowing me to raise a subject pertaining to the interest of the farmers of the country.
You are a senior man, you understand.
Sir, this is a subject pertaining to the interest of the farmers of the country. And particularly, farmers of states like Odisha, Telangana, and to some extent, Tamil Nadu.
Please,
you
are going on record, both of you.
Sir,
please.
Odisha is a petty procuring state.
What Prasanna Acharya goes on record, other things will not go on record.
Sir, Odisha is a petty procuring state like Telangana and a few some other states, sir. And we produce the highest quantity of paddy every year, sir.
Sir, we reported.
Our paddy production in Odisha has been growing consistently over the years.
I will not give a chance next time to you.
During the last 4 or 5 years,
if you defy the chair like this, go against the rules, please.
Procurement of paddy in Odisha, sir.
You made your point.
Sir, we basically, the people of Odisha, the people of Telangana, we can...